Attempting this. It's a very technical singing, very high pitch, and his voice is really not easy to sing. So it's really just blues. We're gonna look how it's made. A lot of licks, of course, can you own, but yeah, so there's an intro, 4 bars and 8 before starting the blues. And go to the octave. Again. This time is faster. Ta 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 Then this famous lick, vibrato, and then this is a cool note. So yeah, after this bend, this is this first A of the bar. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Then here we're in D. So the bass is something like this. I don't. Didn't practice, but so like you see the lead, and then you I use like 2 1, and then in D, you'll hear, and then 2-step bend. And before going to E, this is like, I guess it's in the, it's not pentatonic here. Before going to E, and this is like always sounds good on the fifth chord, because we like doing we're just 2 notes which are in the E chord. So you hold the bend and you go down. It's like open string and double sub, and then sliding. Sorry. Then he goes this position. And then we go to the verse. The verse is like, so I do it like octaves and pull off. Not like this is doing it, but that's what I hear. And the bend here. So you see that the two are not, they are close, but not the same. Sorry. Third time is this, the famous lick. Then we go to D, this time it goes here. And second time, he goes open string. Using arm. I like to roll with my second, so it's easy to pick. So this time on the D, this is the E and D. Like my bag ain't got no bone. So this is like the little loop before starting again the blues. So after the 5, here or here, this J, 5, 4, lick on 4. I'm a bag, ain't got no bone. second verse. So this is a, I like this one. Then this is, so this is kind of a, if you do a A Hendrix chord, but you can like the top note, so it's like the D shape. So that's what he's doing here. Going to a lick. Sorry. So this time, he goes to this before. Oops. This time the fifth chord here. Lick. And then the run before. Third verse. Like he plays while singing. Rock me, baby. Rock me slow. Rock me until. Rock no more. So this is a lick. He's, which he sings. Rock, rock me more. Rock me, baby. Solo here. Open A. And the solo starts here. This always worked well on the first chord. And there too. The same. And can you use those fingers because I stick with the second. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Last one is just before he goes to, we're in the position. This is not common lick, but that's cool. Sorry. Two, seven. Then you go back to A major. Go back to minor. Then on the fifth chord, he's doing like a sixth note per beat. This goes faster. And it's, so it's like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna go fast because soloing is like difficult to explain. It's like raw expression, feeling. That's all the licks that works well in A. B. BB King Bucks. That first position. This is like open strings and use this leg to go back to the first. That's it, guy, for Rock Me Baby. I know it's like super difficult, but I feel like it's so a good song, good solo. I don't know. It seems like everything seems to sit in its place perfect. Really a masterpiece. Like Johnny Winter and blues rock. One of the master with Hendrix. There's a lot of others too, but fuck, I study them, I pay attention what they're doing. I find it's really quality stuff. So yeah, hope you enjoy, have a good practice. And, I know I do the whole song, but even if you do small parts, I hope it can help you, and then you do your own version after. That's what we have to do eventually. So yeah, that's it, guys, and have a good day. See you soon with some new stuff. Peace out.